Hello, in this video we are going to discuss how to calculate the last non-zero digit of any factorial. So let's take an example. So suppose we need to find the last non-zero digit of 8 factorial. Fine. Now 8 factorial, first of all what you need to do is, I'm generalizing it, suppose you need to find the last non-zero digit of n factorial. Now first of all what you need to do is write this n in the form of 5a plus b. इसको इस फॉर्म में लिखेंगे हम. Then your last non-zero digit will be given by the formula 2 raised to power a multiplied by a factorial multiplied by b factorial. So for example, let's take this value 8. So 8, first of all I will try to write 8 in the form of 5a plus b. Now definitely b is less than 5 over here. Fine. So आप इसको हम किस तरह से लिख सकते हैं? 5 into 1 plus 3. So from here we get the value of a as 1 and b as 3. Now if we substitute the value of a and b in this particular formula, we'll get 2 raised to power a, that is 2 raised to power 1 into a factorial into b factorial. So 2 raised to power 1 is 2 into 1 into this is 6. So basically we get 12. So unit digit or last non-zero digit will be 2. And as we know that the value of 8 factorial is 40320. So the last non-zero digit is 2 only. Fine. Now let's move to another example. Suppose we need to find the last non-zero digit of 12 factorial. So first step, write this in the form of 5a plus b. We'll get the value of a as 2 and b as 2 also. So now a is 2 and b is 2. Now what you need to do is, you need to find the last digit of this particular formula, 2 raised to power a into a factorial into b factorial. Iska unit digit hume nikalna hai. Now 2 raised to power 2 into 2 factorial into 2 factorial again. So this is 4 into 2 into 2, which gives us 16, or the unit digit will be 6. Fine. And the value of 12 factorial is 47900 1600. So if you check, the answer is correct. It is 6 only. Fine, last non-zero. Let's take some more examples so that we can have the clarity. So 15. So 15 can be written as 5 into, I need to write in this form. So 5 into A will be 3 and B here is 0. Okay. We cannot write it like this. 5 into 2 plus 5. I have already told you the value of B should be less than 5. Fine. So if we are writing it, we will get the value of A as 3 and B as 0. Again, we'll use the formula 2 raised to power a into a factorial into b factorial, 2 raised to power 3 into 3 factorial into 0 factorial. Now, 0 factorial is 1. Fine. So, this is 8 into 6, which is 48, or the unit digit will be 8. Fine. Now, let's move to another example. 27 factorial. The 27 can be written as 5 into 5 plus 2. So a from here comes out to be 5 and b comes out to be 2. Now 2 raised to power 5 into 5 factorial into 2 factorial. Now 2 raised to power 5 is 32. We know this, right? And 5 factorial. Now see, we have a 5 factorial. Although we know the value of 5 factorial, so it is 120. So yahan se jo last non-zero digit hume mil raha hai, that is 2 only. Fine. 120 mein se hum last non-zero digit ki baat karein, that is 2 and 2 factorial is 2. So, यहाँ पर हम केवल यूनिट डिजिट रख सकते हैं टू यू नो मेक आवर कैलकुलेशन इजी. तो 2 into 2 into 2 will give us 8. So, the unit digit of this particular number will be 8. Fine. Another example, 33 factorial. Now, this 33 factorial, this 33 can be written as 5 into 6 plus 3. So, the value of a from here we get is 6 and b is 3. So, we need to calculate the unit digit of 2 raised to power 6 into 6 factorial into 3 factorial. Now 2 raised to power 6 is 64. 6 factorial, although here also we know the value of 6 factorial is 720 and 3 factorial is 6. Now again here we can remove this 0 because we are looking for the non-zero value. Fine. Or unit digit calculation mein keval unit digit ka hi kaam hota hai. So basically we need to find this product. 8 into 6 is 48. So the unit digit will be 8. Further, suppose 50 factorial is the number. So 50 can be written as 5 into 10 plus 0. So a from here is 10 and b is 0. Now see, although we must be knowing the value of this 10 factorial as well, right? Hame generally yaad rehta hai 10 factorial b, but I will take an example ki suppose hame 10 factorial ka value yaad nahi hai. Now how to solve this, right? So what we will do is to calculate the last non zero digit of this 10 factorial, main again is pe same calculation karunga. So 5 into 2 plus 0. So from here we get the value of a as 2 and b as 0. So the unit digit of 10 factorial will be 2 raised to power 2 into 2 factorial into 0 factorial. So this is 4 into 2, which is 8 only. So iska unit digit is 8. For calculating the unit digit of 2 raised to power 10, we can use the concept of cyclicity. 2 follows the cyclicity of 4. So this is basically 2 raised to power 2 only. Fine. And 0 factorial is 1. So 4 into 8 is 32. So the unit digit of 50 factorial will be 2. Fine. 10 factorial ka jo unit digit aaya tha, that is 8. Aur iska 2 tha, to iska 4 tha, 4 into 2, 32. 32, the unit digit is 2 only. Fine. Now, let us move to one more example. So suppose the number is now 96 factorial. So 96 again can be written as 5 into 19 plus 1. So A from here we get is 19 and B is 1. So now we need to find the unit digit of 2 raised to power 19 into 19 factorial into 1 factorial. Right. Now again 2 raised to power 19, we can use the concept of cyclicity. So this can be written as 2 raised to power 3. Now to calculate the unit digit of 19 factorial, hum wapas se ye process use kar sakte hain. So 19 can be written as 5 into 3 plus 4. So from here we get the value of a as 3 and b as 4. Fine. Now the unit digit will be 2 raised to power 3 into 3 factorial into 4 factorial. So this is 8, 3 factorial is 6 and 4 factorial is 24. So we can remove this 2. So 8 into 6 is 48 into 4. We can again remove this 4. So 8 into 4 will be 32. So the unit digit will be 2 from here. So we substitute it over here. So this is 8 into 2 into 1, which is 16. So the unit digit of this particular number will be 6. Fine. So I hope these examples are clear to you. Thank you.